Hey guys, it's your boy Kerberos, and welcome to my brand new FIFA 17 secondary mode. I have finished the rush in career mode with Carp. Remember, you didn't see the final episode, it went live yesterday. Hey, and now I'm in Belgium, I'm in the Pro League, and I am managing, as you can tell from the title, as you can see on screen, I am the manager of KVC Westerlo. I hope I didn't butcher that. I'm going to have to get used to names and stuff like that. And I was barely getting used to the players in the amp car. I feel like it went so quick. Now, maybe that's because I didn't have European football, but I feel like it really went really quick. So, we'll see. We'll see where we go with this. Actually, this is the first time I'm doing a Belgian career mode in a long time. And this is actually my first time doing a career mode in the Belgian League on YouTube. You know, normally when I do a career mode, I'll just do a career mode with the team I know the best, which is you know, the top teams like Anderlecht. As you guys know, well, with these secondary career modes, I have my team picked randomly from all the teams in the league, and the my decider threw me a curveball like it did with the Russian career mode with Amkar Perm. It threw me Westerlo. So be interested in take this team. No, I'll be expecting much from this team, but I can turn any team into champions. It's dominant. Because I can make any team a Leicester. That's the vibe I have from these guys, similar to the Amkar Perm. I know I'm probably still saying that wrong, but that's the kind of vibe that, you know, there's a team that, you know, you wouldn't expect much from, but what I expect is a fun run. Alright, and it's been a few FIFAs since I've even done a career mode, and in the Belgian league, so you know it's good to get my
flat actually in midfield previously, and
he back into that Belgian water. Or I don't know where I'm going with this analogy. And there we go. There's the first goal of the career mode. The man doesn't know where to go to celebrate. He's freaking running around like a headless chicken. He was almost going to run behind the goal, then he decided to go the complete opposite way. He said, fuck it.
Angle on that goal.
And yes, I'm using the same manager model again. So, Strandberg.
Goal, it's
1-0. Is the scorer of the first goal of the career mode. Play more goals to come, hopefully. Hey.
Comes a challenge.
So yeah, this is the new
on the attack here.
Career mode. Well, a lot of people will know this.
That's a turnover to the opposition.
A lot of people probably wondering why I've chosen Russia then Belgium. I didn't choose Russia or Belgium. With the same way I randomize these my
here's a chance to attack.
The
Well, they've been thwarted here. That's a sign of better things to come.
Yeah, team. I also randomize what order or in what leagues in what order I do, you know?
Good challenge.
It was the Wheels decided. Had a star. For me in the new league. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, maybe you're new subscribers. I use a website called wheeldecide.com. And it will, you just put anything you want in there. If you have a decision made, you can't decide what kind of takeout you want to do, or you know, if you can't decide, maybe like if you have a few movies that you want to see and you say, I can't decide, you know, you can use that. And I highly recommend it. Fantastic, great. Hate the sound effects are pretty cool as well. Well,
trying to switch on
is probably the
well, they're good at corners. Let's see.
I think you still remember or being introduced to it from and
explanation as to why his team are losing. He's not been able to lead from the front line.
And I've never looked back. I've been like anytime I need to a decision to make. Like, I wouldn't use it for a major decision, like a huge life-changing decision, but if I have a, you know, can't decide what game to play or something like that, I will use the decider. It is the wheel, and it's absolute freaking unbelievable website. Yeah, fantastic use. And you can see it gives me different things. It makes the career modes different when I'm being put in charge of teams. People you're probably never gonna likely see the Westerlo win the Pro League. I don't know. Maybe they will someday. Maybe they'll pull a Leicester. I don't know, but just judging from their rating and where they are in the real life table, because when I do take over a team, I do check the table just to see how the real life team doing, how I compare. After a good number of games, the real life Westerlo are, I think, 15th or something like that. They're really low in the table. So, instantly I'm getting a case of a vibe of, okay, They're definitely not a mid-table team, as
it is a miss.
But you know that adds more to it. It really does. It gives me something to work with. It gives me something. It helps me prove my point. And my point in any career mode I do is always that I can make any team a success. I can.
Manage
anyone to success because I am the best manager ever. And I'm not just talking in FIFA terms, I'm talking real life. No one can match up to my accomplishments. And granted, they're all virtual, but you know, I put a lot of hard work over the years to get every accomplishment I've earned. I've never done a career mode where I didn't win in the league and at least one cup.
Some potential in this move. The score!
Now, if Mr. Fine. Cups here and there. I'm not perfect, but I've never had a career mode where I won absolutely nothing. Never. I've always won the league. And the fact that the wheel will put in the Japanese league as the first career mode I did this season, that means I've now won the Japanese league, so I still have a record of doing and having at least won every single league. Now, granted, you haven't always seen that. You're probably saying, we've never seen you in the Saudi League. The Saudi League is on my randomizer. It might pop up before the end of FIFA 17 with the way we're going. I mean, we're getting through these freaking career modes like nobody's business.
Yeah.
Especially if I keep getting teams that have no European football. And even if I get a team with European football, if it's not the Champions League, I'm just gonna take them out of the European football. So the career mode will be the only league. Now, it hasn't happened yet, right? Because I did want to win the Europa League once, and I did that with Leo. Now I've won it with Leo, and I know it's going to happen eventually. Somewhere between now and the end of FIFA 17, as we're all getting ready for FIFA 18 to come out.
Good through pass.
Once I've done, at this rate, I might even get through almost all the leagues. Now, if I happen to get a team that the game puts in the Europa League, I will take them out. I will. But I don't want it to sound confusing. So you may think, oh, he'll just disable the European football and there'll be no European football. No. I did it with the Russian career mode. And I've done it with this career mode as well. I've enabled the European football. Just because I'm not in it doesn't mean my rivals don't have to be in it. I mean, Anderlecht are in the Europa League, and I think Ghent are in Standard Liège, who I'm playing. I think they're in European football as well.
There's only a minute to go.
So, I want those taxing games to take their toll. Well, the Champions League, they'll get a bit of rest period. But with the Europa League, if I get Anderlecht after a Europa League game, I'm gonna reap the reward. Their players will be tired. They'll have to do some rotation and stuff like that. So, positive options will come from enabling the European football. So, the European football will be enabled, I just won't be taking part in it unless my team is in the Champions League. I know that might sound a bit stupid, or I don't know what else you guys might think, but I've already won the Europa League. I have no reason to win it again, and to put a team that may not have the squad depth to deal with it. I mean, I won the Europa League with Leo, who didn't have the squad depth. They really didn't. If I had realized ahead of time that they didn't have the squad depth, I wouldn't have put them in the Europa League. I would have taken them out. Now, some of you will probably say to yourself, okay, if you're going to take the teams out, who are you replacing with? Simple. I will look at the league table. I will pull from the previous season. I will look at where the team I get picked as finished, and I will look at who finished below them. Similar to how the Premier League does it. If the Premier League has, say, this has happened in someone, I think. Actually, I think this has happened with Liverpool before. Or I think Liverpool are the reason this really came into effect. In that we didn't finish in the top four for that year, but because of what we did in the Champions League, we got put in instead of the team who finished in fourth. If I remember correctly, I think that was Chelsea? No, wait. Chelsea won the league in 05. Who finished fourth in 05? Was it Arsenal? No, I think that was before Arsenal started finishing fourth every year. It wasn't Manchester United. It wasn't Chelsea. It might have been Everton. I can't think of the table from a few years ago off the top of my head. But anyone with better memory will be like, oh, I remember that. Yeah. But that's what they did. Since Liverpool didn't win the... Didn't finish in the top four, but because we did it did well in the Champions League, we got put in instead of the team that we're supposed to be at. And that team was pissed. Liverpool actually finished fifth that season. That was what caused all the commotion, is because we didn't finish in the top four, but we had won the Champions League. So, everyone was confused of what the hell that means. So FIFA just put us in. The one and only time they were ever good to us. I know, it was crazy. Yeah, I know. Well, the thing. They actually did something nice for Liverpool. It was a really confusing day. We were all really confused as to what the fuck was going on. We're like, wait, what? You're being nice to us? This is new. Is this some kind of, are you trying to punk us? Is this some sort of joke? No, they were genuine. So. Good on them. You notice I signed two new players that are on loan. One actually came from Manchester United, ironically. Pool. Probably butchering his name, even though it's English. I think he's English, anyway. I'm looking in to get a bit of squad depth, just to add to my defensive options. I'm looking at possible transfers as well, as you saw there. I'm going to focus more on that between this and next episode, because we're only going into July. This is still the first month of the transfer window, so I'll delete those off camera because there's way too many. Yeah, there's way too many emails. Scanning a lot of layers. That's just gauging on how much effort I'm putting into this. Because I'm scouting my ass off. You probably noticed my balance. Yes, I did use a financial takeover. And no, idiots, before someone says, oh, that's against... That defeats the purpose of building the team up. Have you seen my team ratings? I only made one signing. I didn't get that much money. I only got like 35 million. I mean, I can build a fucking kick-ass team with 35 million without a doubt. It's about picking diamonds in the rough. If you ever seen and that's the whole point of that saying. When you pick someone with potential. You pick them out and you say, hey, I'll take you to this club and I'll make you a superstar. That's what I'm doing. Boom, you make them a superstar. And for those of you wondering, only Westerlo fans will probably notice the difference. It's actually the guy on
for the home team. Look, oh, he's through.
He's a left midfielder, but he's playing at right. This guy. I brought him in, and you can see his stats. He's Nigerian. He's 19 years old. Well, 70, right? And, you know, this guy could have... He could be an urgent, and I found completely by accident. I have never heard of this guy. I'm not gonna pretend I know anything about this guy. I'm not gonna pretend I know if he's a superstar in the making or if he's just happens to be a decent young player. Or I don't know anything about this guy. I've done my research yet into anything like that. Ignore that. That's counting preseason, which we all know doesn't count. Because he did not score 3 goals and 4 goals in the last game. That's for damn sure. Especially because I didn't even score. I only scored half that amount of goals, and one of the goals was an own goal against Tenderly H. Which one of their own players defeating the purpose of being a defender and trying to do defensive duty.
This could be it. Shots on here. Hit the post!
Off the post! The rebound! And the sick. And, well, third goal for the team. And it's the second one scored by an actual player, or from the team. This time it's number 35, as opposed to the guy who scored in the first game. I think that's actually the guy they were showing off a few minutes ago, who had the 4 goals in 3 games. Yep, Sylvester Ganola? Ganola? I'm probably complete. Ganvola. Okay. I'm gonna... That's gonna be probably the best I get. That's probably as close as I'm gonna get. And... It's either the player I showed you guys earlier, the Nigerian. You can see him there trying to win the ball. It's either him or someone else I'm chasing after one of my transfer target. Actually plays for this team. I think it's someone else. It might be the Nigerian dude. If they happen to mention that... I haven't seen anything about mentioning him playing against his former club. And he's actually in here. Oh wait, no, that's a Henry dude. That's a different thought. I'm trying to tell them apart by their number, because I didn't realize until and I haven't learned off all the numbers yet.
Not there when needed, the goalkeeper.
Because I mean, when I saw
looking at him, having words,
I saw the back of him. I couldn't quite see the back of his jersey. So, yeah.
The manager will go into this with extra zest, really. Played 1-1. What's going to happen in game number two?
I don't know if they're talking about...
The players will be gaining respect for him.
Or if indeed they are... Wait, is that him? Oh no, wait, that is him. I think Henry might be his first name. Oh no, it is! Okay. Okay, so I was right, it was him. I was wondering why Henry was kind of, you know, Henry is obviously his first name. I did not know that. I didn't check what his first name was. I was more interested in what he could offer to the team. I wasn't too worried about first names and stuff like that. We can learn the names later. That's not important right now. But has gotten his first goal for the club, and it might be against the former club. I can't quite remember. I think it's either this club or some other club with black and white. It's either him or it's one of my transfer targets. I think the guy is actually a CDM, which is why I'm thinking it might be a transfer target. He's either a CDM or a center back, and I'm looking into a shit ton of players, I'm not gonna lie. I'm sure I improved the team as best as I can, and well, yes, I will. I can't change everything. I mean, I could, but 100%, I mean, I could get unbelievable bargains, and I mean, I have about 30 million, and say 10 players, that would be average about 3 million a player, depending on where I feel I would need more for investment, if I need more investment in certain areas. But, you know, looking at this team, we'll see what I do. I think a center back is the most logical choice. I do want to bring in maybe another option at the right hand side, because again, the team seems to has three left backs, but they don't really have a decent choice for the right hand side. I mean, they have two choices, but they are pretty much not. They are not that different. They seem like they'd offer the same deal. Yeah. I do want to put my own spin on this team. You know, I could easily make no changes and still accomplish the same thing, because, as I said, that's just how it works.
He's the kind of player that could make a difference.
Ears just don't recognize. Yeah, I can. The whole reason I do financial takeovers is, you know, I want to put my own spin on the team and improve them in my way. And some teams was required for that bit of finance just to help with that.
He's had a go here. He's got to it, and he's claimed the ball too.
cut out the pass. Turnover of possession here. Got it back again from his teammate. Good position. They've worked this attack very well into a quite a dangerous position now. Where there's life, there's hope, but there's not much life in the game.
Oh, he's come on, nice over the top ball. Oh, you got to be kidding me.
That's great defending there, stopping that attack.
If you're wondering where I said, what was coming up? Excuse me. I don't know why I'm yawning. And it's the middle of the fucking day.
15 minutes to go. He's had to tackle there to concede the corner.
If you couldn't tell, that was sarcasm. It's not really the middle of the day. It is currently 10 to 11. And that's at night. Because
well, you thought there was only one winner there.
I sometimes get distracted by things.
And the goalkeeper has done well to stop that one.
I have no words. I have no words for what just happened there. A great ball through, and I fucking rolled into the keeper. And that's not the first time I've done that. I'm not putting enough power into a lot of shots. Whenever sometimes I'll roll it to the keeper and I'll be like, oh, for God's sake, not again. Okay, this time, no messing around. Okay, my player doesn't want to give me an option in that situation. Hey, at least the ball found its way to the keeper. I have to shoot it from range. But, you know, that's a foul.
Set piece specialist here with this free kick.
That's something I need to do as well. Oops, look at that. And set.
Going well for the home players.
Free kick takers. Ooh, I was close. Not bad. Hey, considering he might not be who I want on my free kicks. The only reason I took it with him is because it's who the game put on it. A good start to the season. Two wins, both 2-0. Cool. Oddly enough. Good. What outcome from those first two games? Yes, your man gets his first goal over the court. Well, again, involved. Hola gets his first goal for the main season. And continuing in the form you saw him that he was performing with in preseason. And that's two wins from two. So, great start. Right. And kicks off my run in the Pro League Insta. And it leaves me he joined with three other teams as I sit in second. And it's just behind Zolt T. Wargaram. Yeah. But, not a bad start, and okay, so that was his former club. Because it says up here, Noah Alas for, and that's his surname, on Yekru. On Yekru. I'm gonna have to learn how to say that. So, that's something for me to work on between now and the next episode. Which is probably gonna be recorded immediately after this one. Yeah. Until then, and thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button and subscribe. And so you don't miss any future content, including remainder of this career mode. It's gonna be a long journey to hopefully winning the Belgian and league. I say hopefully I will win it. Let's be honest here. And win the Belgian Cup. I don't know when I have my first game in that. Okay, now I do. November. And wouldn't you know it? It's standard. The Liège. Yeah. They just enjoy being the first opponents and things, don't they? Yeah. Until then, thanks for watching. Enjoy. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.